Samantha Bee and Trevor Noah weighed in on the damage caused by Hurricanes Harvey and Irma, and the latest in the Russia investigation. Late-night hosts on Wednesday addressed the fallout from Hurricanes Irma and Harvey, the latest developments in Robert Mueller's Russia investigation, and the violence against the Rohingya minority in Myanmar. Last week, members of Congress returned from their summer vacations, which were awesome, Samantha Bee began. Paul Ryan blew off some steam in Venice while Mitch McConnell made his annual trip to Melbourne Beach. But now Congress is back and demanding answers. Why didn't Equifax tell us they'd been hacked? Why can't T. Don Jr. pick one lie and stick with it? Bee mentioned Ted Cruz's Twitter gaffe, in which the senator liked a pornographic video on social media website. The Texas chugger gave Twitter its most joyful night since CovFef, but he isn't the only Republican having a bad week, Bee continued, referring to the many members of the GOP who were shocked by Trump's decision to strike a deal with Democrats to raise the debt ceiling for 3 months. The host then showed several Fox News clips describing the GOP response to the deal, each of which characterized Republican politicians as blindsided by the news. "Whoa, knock it off with the incendiary language, Fox," Bee said. "If you say blindside one more time, Sandra Bullock will magically appear and force you to move in with her until you become a football star." Bee continued, "But of course, the big news is Mother Earth's quest to murder us all. Did you know that everything west of the Rockies is on fire? Maybe not as hard to go full CNN on an inferno, but a solid month of hurricanes? That, they got." Bee showed footage of the CNN broadcaster Chris Cuomo, which saw him braving the storm and talking to residents of affected areas. "Is this really necessary?" Bee asked. "We're not all Rush Limbaugh. We will believe you if you report on the storm from indoors. I make fun of Chris for caring about people's safety, because I am an asshole, but preparedness and good information saves lives, whether it was Governor Scott and his army of sign language interpreters, or firefighters checking in on vulnerable residents, or police reminding folks not to fire guns at the hurricane," Bee quipped. "State officials did everything they could to keep people safe, and that includes something they did way back in 1992 after Hurricane Andrew, Florida enacted 6 building codes to make sure that every marine theme park, strip joint, and combination thereof was built to withstand extreme weather. As our EPA chief keeps telling desperate coastal mayors, this is not the appropriate time to talk about climate change," Bee said. "The appropriate time will be when we're all on a space station trying to figure out how to turn our poop into protein bars." Seth Meyers of NBC weighed in on the latest in the Russia investigation, which the special counsel Robert Mueller has escalated in recent weeks. Now after a long summer of bizarre missteps and scandals, Trump is dealing with everything from hurricane cleanup to keeping the government funded, he said. And on top of that, there are new details in the rapidly escalating Russia investigation. The special counsel in that investigation, Robert Mueller, is now reportedly focused specifically on Trump's decision to fire former FBI Director James Comey. According to Axios, Mueller is burrowing in hard on the obstruction of justice angle, the host explained. Republicans close to the White House say every sign by Mueller is that he's going for the kill. Myers then showed an image of Mueller, adding that he looks like the police chief from every 1950s noir film. Mueller's investigation seems to be moving very quickly, and has ensnared not only Trump, but some of his closest aides, such as his son-in-law and advisor Jared Kushner, Myers continued. Kushner repeatedly failed to disclose meetings with Russian officials, and now it looks like even some of Trump's own lawyers knew Kushner would be a liability. The host then showed news reports claiming that the president's lawyers, expecting Kushner to find himself in legal jeopardy, had begun drafting Kushner's resignation letter. "Jared Kushner resign?" Myers asked. "But then who would be in charge of U.S.-China relations, U.S.-Mexico relations, criminal justice reform, opioid crisis management, veteran care reform, the White House Office of American Innovation, revamping the entire federal government, painting the Easter eggs for the Easter egg hunt, and peace in the Middle East?" Trevor Noah talked about Myanmar, and what the UN's top human rights official has called textbook ethnic cleansing. "Let us take a moment and talk about the Nobel Peace Prize," Noah began. "There is nothing more prestigious that you can win. It is like getting an Oscar for being a good person instead of acting like a good person. But the Peace Prize is on my mind because, recently, Myanmar has been popping up on our news feeds. It is a country of 50 million people situated between India, China, and Taiwan.